Greetings, friends. This is the Effectrode compressor, the model PC-2A photo optical tube compressor. It contains a lovely sub-miniature tube, and it contains a photo cell, and it has a lot in common with the old classic Teletronics LA-2A studio compressor of old. In fact, I think you'll find that that's what Phil Taylor has modeled it on. It is completely Class A analog. It runs off 12 volt DC, wants about 350 milliamps of current to drive it, and it is totally transparent. On the rear of the PC-2A you will find a little toggle switch which lets you switch between compression and limiting, and of course the limiting is a little more severe than compression, so I'll give you a demonstration of exactly what it does in a moment. The foot switch is silent, that helps a lot as well. This is an old 2002, I think, Fender Standard Telecaster with Mick Breeley's Burgerman signature pickups in it, and they are running through to the clean channel of a Laney VH100R, my favourite clean amp, because it is so clean, and a 412 cab with greenbacks in it. Clean sound is like this. Alright, first our PC-2A in compression mode, and we'll start off with our ratio at around the 9 o'clock mark. Straight away we get a lovely sound. It's not sucking out any bass, it's not adding any treble, it's just making the sound a little bit wider. The PC-2A has a very fast attack, so you don't get that rotten pumping sound that I personally can't stand in compressors. There's none of that going on here, sir. Just beautiful. Let's up the peak reduction for a moment. Peak reduction is kind of the same as the compression ratio. Now you can hear that that compression ratio has kicked in, so we're going to want to turn it up a little more. Very nice. Inside you'll find trim pots to adjust the knee and the attack as well. If you're recording bass with active pickups or acoustic instruments with piezo pickups or things like that, they will come in very handy because you can use this in the studio. It will do a fine job. Without it. With it again. Let's drive this peak reduction all the way. Still no pumping. That's a very good thing. Country players are going to love this. Just hangs on. I'll do it without it now. The same, is it? So the more I decrease that peak reduction, the less compression ratio and the more that gain is going to be made up. which means I've got to turn it down a little bit. Usually, unless I'm going to use the amp's drive channel. Just a little bit of breakup there. I can use the gain control here to give it even more crank. Back to the clean channel. I want to have a look at this limiting toggle. So I've thrown it into limiting now and clean sound. You can hear that it's a much, much bigger sound. The more I increase this peak reduction, the more it's going to squish. And it does squish too. You can hear the threshold going, ah, but there's no pumping. Great. That's cool. You could actually use it as a mono mastering sort of limiting device if you wanted to in the studio. Have two of them, even one on each channel. That would be a good idea, wouldn't it? This is the photo-optical tube compressor, model PC-2A from Effectrode. Phil Taylor has written a very long and comprehensive treatise in the actual manual, which you would be advised to download and have a good read of, because this is one top-quality piece of gear. Check it out. See ya.